What's up, guys? TJ here from Rugby Hustle, and I've been asked by Mark, and we've been asked a few times by a number of people, how often you should be training to improve your game of rugby, particularly in the gym, but how often you should be training as a general rule of thumb. Now, it's hard to give a definitive answer because it massively depends on you, your work schedule, your motivation for rugby. If you're not really motivated at the time, there's no point going to the gym because that's just going to beat down your motivation even more. You're better off going less often, getting really productive sessions out of that. Also depends, like I say, on your work schedule, your free time, when you can actually go, and also your current goals as well. So I'm just going to note down now, so if we're talking about how you can improve at rugby, there's a ton of different things that you can be doing in the gym. You don't have to be doing strength work every time, because that's going to be a limit. You could, same thing with power work, you can't just do it every time. Same thing with trying to get muscle hypertrophy. You can't just go to the gym every day for the same goal. So what we like to do is we've got a number of different programs and sessions that have got different goals in mind that you can then combine to go to the gym every day or even more often, even twice a day, even up to three different times a day, because there are so many different areas that you can have a session on to try and improve your game of rugby. So I want to quickly try and note as many of them down as I can, and you'll see that there's so many sessions that you can try and fit into a game. Now, if you haven't got the free time or if you haven't got the motivation, concentrate on your strength work, on your power work, on what your main goals are for rugby. Concentrate on those areas first, because the rest of it is all a bit of a luxury, but if you can do it, then fair play, go and do it. So we've got weight sessions you can do, and you can do, if you're doing weight training, you can do strength work, you can do power work, you can do hypertrophy work, so that's muscle growth. You can go into the gym and do weights to just improve your technique. So if you're trying to be an Olympic lifter, or if you're trying to really learn how to do the snatch to clean and jerk, or if you're trying to learn certain movements that are quite high skilled movements, muscle ups another one, if you're trying to learn different techniques, then you can go and just have a session just to try and get that technique right. It's not going to be heavy enough that it's going to really try and knacker you out, it's going to be fine, so you can just do a technique one. You can also do another one, stretch it out here, where you can just do core work. You can have a whole session, half an hour, just do a load of different movements, really trying to embrace the core. You can work core stability, core strength, the twist rotation as well, and anti-rotation. So there's loads of different work you can be doing just with the weights. So like you can even add in a speed session as well, so you could do weights that's almost covered by power, but you've also got flat out speed that you can do with weights as well. So that's a ton of different ways already. Then we've also got conditioning, where with conditioning you can do you can incorporate some skill work, so you can do skills drills that incorporate conditioning. You can do intervals, you can do both sprinting intervals, and you can do intervals that are on the rower or on a bike or even in the pool where you're off your feet, so you're not working too much on the running. You can do steady state, which isn't overly going to have too much of a benefit for rugby, but it can just improve your condition by that little bit if you're trying to fit in a third session in that day. If you're really in a tough training camp, you can also do speed work, and again this has a ton of facets to it as well, so you can work speed technique, you can work speed to a top end speed, so where you're really flat out, anything over 50, 60 meters, you're working top end speed, or you can be sprinting downhill or go get an overspeed treadmill as well. You can also do speed endurance work. That can also cross over with a bit of conditioning as well. So where you're just doing speed work in lots of time, so you will feel that quite, that'll be pretty tough. You can do acceleration work. And so you can see here where we've only got these three, so weight work, conditioning work, and speed work, and you've got all these different sessions that you can split up into different sessions. So you can do four different strength sessions a week, plus two where you're working your technique because you want to learn the Olympic lifts. Then you've got another two where you can work your core a little bit. Then maybe you're doing a few sprints and then a bit of steady state conditioning off your feet to try and alleviate too much fatigue that you could get over time. Then there's also stuff, if you're training quite a lot, then it might be worth your while to get into the gym even more and do mobility work, because if you're doing lots of lifting, then you need to make sure you're working on your mobility so you can get your recovery. So you'll be doing foam rolling, just your basic stretching sessions. You'll be doing mobility movements. You can even do things to increase your recovery, like a yoga session would be pretty beneficial as well. And these sort of things where you're looking at mobility, so maybe even this can also be mobility and recovery. So you could do a pull session or a light cardio session, similar to the steady state we've got here, where you're doing it just to get the blood moving so that you can have fresh blood in and you can recover better. But here you can see there is a ton of different ways that you can train in the gym that aren't just doing the same old programs at all, but you can keep improving. So you can easily get up to 2-3 sessions a day where you're looking at different facets to improve your physical condition as well. This isn't even mentioning, we've got a bit of skills work there, so that'd be like rucking specific conditioning or passing, where you're doing lots of passing under stress. But this isn't even your skill work as well on top of that, so your main rugby practice. So there's a ton of different ways. I'll also add in the fact that in mobility and recovery, these sessions, rather than adding to your fatigue, they'll actually take away from this. So you'll feel a lot fresher for doing them. So you'll feel better. If you're doing a pull session, you wouldn't think to do that would make you more tired. It'll actually make you better, so you can fit in even more sessions as you go. But then, obviously, these mobility and recovery sessions will take away from your free time. So really, it's massively variant on what your goals are, but massively variant on the amount of free time you've got. We've got a lot of students that follow us now at Rubber Muscle, so you've got to look at around your lectures. You boys will have a lot of free time compared to when you're going to be in your normal working life. So whilst you're also at the age where you're going to get the most physical benefit from doing good training as you would do anyway, you've also got more free time probably than you would do later on in your life when you're actually doing a proper working career or whatever. So use this time that you've got available to you now and think of all these different ways that you can use your time, use the gym, or even just out on the pitch, and really try and improve your work capacity and improve yourself as a physical athlete for rugby. Now, if you're not sure where to go on these different exercises, we also offer our academy program is global, our online membership service, where we've got different parts, or we've got all of these bases covered for you, and we'll tell you how to fit them in along with your strength training at the moment. For those of you that are doing the Gorilla Protocol, that's just a strength/hypertrophy program where we're working a little bit of mobility, but that's it. So you've got all this extra scope to improve yourself as a player, and we've got that covered for you in the academy. So I'll put a link in below to see if you want to join the academy. But if not, no worries. Have a look at these different sessions and let us know how this could help you. And if you've got any questions that you want to ask us, just send us an email, info@rugby-muscle.com. And we'll hopefully make a video for you, or not, we'll reply to your email, and we'll want to help you guys become the best rugby players that you can be. So cheers.